Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's video, I'm going to cover seven items in Excel that people frequently ask me about. And this is usually when someone's been using Excel for a little bit and kind of moving into that more intermediate phase. All of these are extremely easy, but great time-saving tips. Let's dive in right now. So number one is moving columns. This was intentional. If you look, I've got column 5, column 4, column 6, column 5. I put column 5 in yellow. Select it. Two easy ways to move it and put it here before column 6. One of my favorite methods is I am holding down the shift key. I'm left clicking. I hope you see that my mouse cursor is changing. It's basically saying, where do you want to drop this? Well, I want to drop it between E and F. I'm going to let go of the mouse. Done. Let go of shift and I'm done. I'm going to undo that. Method 2, if you didn't like that method, I can right click on the column. So now I'm not holding down shift. I'm right clicking, pulling over, and this is going to be a shift right and move. That method works too. I think I prefer the shift left click method. The next example, if you notice, in these numbers, I use the ran between function to get these numbers in here because I didn't feel like typing in numbers. This is for training, but I want to paste the values. I see a lot of people do a right click, copy, right click, paste values. All you have to do is right click, pull back, and it's going to say, hey, what do you want to do? And I want to copy here as values only. Notice now there is no ran between up in the formula bar. So that's paste values. I know this sounds crazy, but people on autofill, alt equal is auto sum, and autofill, just double click to autofill down. That is tip number 3. Also included with that one, this has to do with auto sum still. I need to auto sum all the numbers to the left. I need a total on the right, and I need a total down below. Notice I picked up the range and I stopped where I wanted my totals. Now you can do alt equal and it'll auto sum automatically. There you go. So now I don't have to do auto fill. So there's auto sum and auto fill combined together. I am going to do a couple undos. There I go. Back to just my data. The next tip I get asked about, I believe this is number 5, I hope so. I just covered this week, but I get asked about this all the time, and it is flash fill. Over here in column L, I've got names and departments. I am making this up. I need to see just the names. Maybe this data came to me this way. So Chris Menard, Sue, there you go. There's flash fill right there. I could have gone the other way, by the way, and put in the departments and got just the departments there. If you like that video, it is up above. It's also down below. The next tip I have for you is creating a table. This one's probably of all the ones I'm doing today, of the 7 tips, I'm doing the most advanced. But then when I explain people why to use a table instead of a range, they get all excited. So here you go. This is a range. Notice it does not say table design up here. It is control T. Do you want to create a table? Do you have a header row? Sure, I hit OK. Now I got a table. In case you're wondering why in the world would I want to make a table out of this? Let me fix that real quick. Why in the world would you want to make a table? Multiple reasons for making a table. There's at least 15 reasons, but what's cool is if I make a chart out of this, Alt F1, there's my chart, and I come in here and add a new column, type in some numbers, I'll keep it simple. There is column 8 right there, so my chart picks up that my table has new data in it. That applies both going to new columns and adding new rows. So if you're doing pivot tables, charts, and you update the table, you can quickly refresh and update your data there. If not, it's a lot of work to go back and change the range. So use a table. One other cool reason about tables, so I'm still talking about tables, is I now have table design because I made a table. You can add a total row down here. It'll always total the last column. But you can sit here and you can continue to total other columns. If you don't want totals, you can do averages. Cool feature, and just turn that off. And finally, the status bar. Somebody will send me data. I said, hey, well, your maximum value is this, and this is your lowest value. And they say, well, how do you know that? Well, just simply highlight whatever you want to. I'll do this range right here. I've already turned these on, but it'll say sum, average, and count down here. Go ahead and right-click. Turn on everything from average to sum. I know I just made a video about status bar. It's up in the top also, and I'll put it down also in the description. So there you go. If you have any other cool tips, by the way, if you're an Excel user, whether you're a trainer or not, I don't care, but if you show people stuff and they go, oh, I didn't know that, please let me know in the comments down below. I may include that in a follow-up video. Please subscribe if you want to. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.